Welcome to MCTV. My name is Dennis Doyle, and I'm here at Midland High School with Dave Milne to cover the Saginaw Valley dual meet between the visiting Chargers from Dow High and the Chemics of Midland High. The Chargers come into tonight's dual meet with a record of 6-4, and the Chemics are 5-1. Up first at 125 pounds, we have Andrew Murdutt from Dow High and Nick Norris from Midland High. We've got 3 2-minute periods here. First period, the wrestlers are starting in neutral. A quick shot and sprawl there.
All right. Little shot. And right now, guy in green is trying to pull the knee in so we can take him down. The guy in blue is trying to sprawl out, get his weight on top of the Dow High kid.
Dow High wrestler's trying to get him up and get behind his hips for control and get a takedown, which is worth 2 points.
Well, if he gets that hip to the mat, he's going to be in a good situation.
Yeah, I think Andrew's got to get his head out from underneath.
Just to get off his knees, too, but Nick has his ankle, so stalemate it is.
Got a stalemate by the official, which means that no advantage was getting taken place by either wrestler, so they're going to start him back neutral. Another shot
nice
by
shot
Andrew.
There.
That's nice defense by Nick. Andrew got in there pretty deep, and Nick is defending it well.
Almost back into the same position they just were in.
Mm-hmm. Andrew's got to get him up a little bit and get him off his ankle and maybe sit through those legs. Got to come off his knees.
Looks like he's trying to run around the side there. Yep. If he can finish that up. Did the ref just blow the whistle?
And that was from the other mat, the Bay City Western Arthur Hill match going on. So these kids have to make sure they're paying attention. Nick's really got to crank down on that
head. Out and
Nick's got to push that head under, head under to make it easier for him to get his hips away and get that leg back.
It's been the same thing the whole period. He's got to bring it in and
all right, that's the end of period one. We're at 0-0.
Red's choice. Red defers.
So that means Midland. Go ahead, Dave. I'm sorry.
I was going to say Midland High just deferred to Dow and let them choose.
Yep. Andrew Murdutt from Dow chose the bottom position. If he gets up and gets what they call an escape for 1 point, he's got to get to his feet and separate.
Looks like he's almost there. He just needs to get his hips away.
Run away.
Walk his hips away, but he's just staying still.
There we go. That's 1 point for Andrew Murdutt. Back in the neutral position.
Finish that one.
Takedown. So that's worth 2 points. Andrew's a sophomore at Dow High, and Nick is a freshman. Nick's got a little bit of middle school experience, and Andrew's got some middle school and a little bit of youth experience as well. So far, they're pretty evenly matched. Nick's got 12 wins on the season with 7 losses. Nick's trying to work his way out of there to get himself an escape and get a point on the board. Andrew returning back to the mat. Andrew's got to work to get a pinning combination or the referee may call stalling.
Looked like he tried to throw a leg in there, but it didn't work. As long as he holds on to him or if he pushes him out of bounds, he's not going to lose them point for an escape.
Right, yeah, there was no
block call. Who's that? Andy is going to lose or give up a point there.
Yep, Nick's going to get one point awarded to him for Andrew locking his hands while they were on the mat. You can only lock your hands on an opponent when you're in a pinning combination. And so Andrew must have touched his hands, and they awarded Nick a point. Andrew's working to try and get some near fall, and Nick keeps working to get that escape, wants to get up to his feet.
Looks like he's trying to put in a bundle, but he's letting Nick stand up, and that's not going to work if he stands up.
All right. Okay, end of period two. It will be Midland High's choice. He can choose neutral, or he can choose down position or top position, and it looks like Nick's going to choose a down position. Nick also ran track at Midland High. He was going to run track at Midland High. He must have run track at Northeast. And Andrew runs track at Dow High and also plays on the JV football team. Looks like he's trying to get a half.
As long as he keeps his weight on him this time, he's trying to get that bundle in. He needs to get his right arm underneath, but that didn't work out.
We've got another half. Nick is getting that hand out of there nicely. He knows if Andrew gets the half in, he's going to be able to turn him to his back. Looks like
he's getting a cradle
getting
in
a cradle
it looks
in
like.
There, maybe, or trying.
No, he doesn't seem to be having a lot of luck getting stuff in on Nick.
He's definitely high there. not a good position for Andrew,
happens.
But Andrew
as long as he can hold on to that leg, he won't give up a point. Trying for a cradle, but he's probably just push him out of bounds.
That was a nice move by Nick. He felt Andrew getting a little high on him and about dumped Andrew over his back. There was a nice scramble there, and no points were earned.
As long as he can hold on another minute, he'll be all set. Really, if you can even let him escape, as long as he doesn't get reversed.
Yeah, if he gets reversed, then it's a tie game. So Andrew's looking to, he's going to give something up here. It'd be 1 point. And not a two-point reversal. Andrew's still in control. Ref is signaling that he's still in control and that Nick has not gotten away yet. Got another stalemate. There's 21 seconds left in the match. Andrew just can't give up anything big here, a big 5-point reversal, or give up a reversal to near fall. He'd be all right. Boy, Nick shot out of there nicely. He really exploded.
That was fast. And he's
hanging on
really
the leg there.
All right, he got 11 seconds left on the clock.
Yep, and they
as
just
long as Andy, I think the ref just gave him a point.
Yep.
As long as Andy doesn't get taken down, he's gonna.
Yeah, they awarded him a point. It actually should be 3-2. They awarded Nick a point for stalling by Andrew Merdutt.
I thought they were giving him the escape. No, but that's it.
That was a tight match. Andrew Merdutt came out on top.
That was a hard fight for both of them.
Yes. Up next, we're going to have at the 130-pound weight class, we've got Sam Martin from Dow High, who's a freshman, and
David Ware.
David Ware is actually injured. He's not participating. I believe this is Jacob Gamala. Jacob Gamala is also a freshman, and he and Sam both have a good amount of youth experience under their belt, so this could be a good match. David Ware, one of Midland High's senior leaders, was not able to compete today. We hope that he's back in action soon.
Do you know what happened to him?
He, I believe, had a concussion at one of the tournaments, and they're using safety and following the protocol and making sure that he's 100% before he comes back. So Gamala got a very nice high crotch, and Martin countered that nicely and ended up getting the two-point takedown. Looks like he's trying to work in a crotch pry and a half Nelson. Sammy's a bit longer than Jacob, has those long arms. He's tough when he gets on top. Jacob's a pretty strong kid and may have that edge over Sam Martin. And actually, I had said
reversed him right there.
Yeah, Jacob's in a good position right now. If he comes
trying to work out the back.
Yeah, comes out the back door, he's going to get 2 points reversal. And actually, Jacob, I said he was a freshman. Jacob is actually a sophomore. All right, so Sam Martin still in control. Jacob's pretty explosive, so he's going to have to. Sammy's going to have his work cut out to ride him. Trying to stand up, and Sammy caught that arm and brought him down. Sam's got an arm bar right now, where trying to control his arms and work him into a pinning combination or get him to his back to get some near fall. And Jacob's got to work to either get a reversal or an escape. Good scrambling here. Jacob's working hard. Sam's riding him well.
Well, now that he's got Sammy's leg, looks like he's going to get that reversal, right. But Sammy made it a stalemate last time he got in that position.
Sam was able to
and
get a leg in. Yeah, it looked like Jacob was going to get his hips up high and be able to come out of that and score at least one, but Sammy got his leg around and threw a leg in and was able to take control. It was Green's choice, and Sam Martin deferred to the third period, and Jacob Gamala chose top.
So they must be trying to pin Sammy. They must not be very confident they can win this otherwise.
On their feet. Yeah, a lot of times wrestlers will choose the down position. If there's been scoring in the first period, the person with the choice will choose the down position. A little easier to score that way.
Looks like Sammy's trying to reverse, but no, does he have that arm? He does. He's got his arm around his leg. Now he gave it up. Mm-hmm.
Jacob had the legs laced there with his body, which makes it tough to get out of there. Sammy's got to run those hips away.
Now he's scrambling hard, and
Jacob's doing a nice job.
Trying to break him down. Way to move from one breakdown to another right there.
Yeah, there's no shortage of movement here by Jacob. If you stay on the hips too long, you can get called or cautioned for stalling, and you never want that. You gotta get off the bottom wrestler's hips and allow him to come up into his hips and get those hips in the air. If you stay on the hips too long, you can get called for stalling, and Jacob's doing a nice job of going from move to move to prevent that. Sammy looks like he could back out of there, get one. As a bottom wrestler, a lot of times you get an opportunity to get an escape, and you try to go for the two-point reversal, and you end up getting nothing.
Oh, you get.
Got about 18 seconds left in the period. Sammy's going to keep scooting his hips into him.
Going to try and come around. Think he's going to make it in the next seven seconds.
Only five down to five. Oh, he did.
Yep,
he gave
he
him
did.
Two-point reversal, and that must have happened when Sammy got his right leg around Jacob's hip, and that gave him control. So it's Sammy's choice right now, and he chose bottom position. He's up 4-0, and Jacob's going to have to put him on his back, get some back points or a pin if he wants to win this match.
2 minutes to escape, and he went right back down. Mm-hmm. And now,
Sammy's got him a spladle.
Reversal, and I got him on his back.
Yep. So Sammy has at least 2 points reversal and 3 points near fall. He's got him in what's called a spladle. And there's a pin for Sam Martin.
Still at 6 points to battle score.
That was a real nice transition by Sam Martin. That Spladel's difficult to get out of, and Jacob fought that real tough.
He moved into it real smooth, too.
Mm-hmm. Coming up next at the 135-pound weight class, we've got...
Hey, go to work! Let's go!
We've got Matthew Ware, who is a sophomore, and we have Justin Liakos, who is actually stepping in for Michael Moore. This is actually Justin's first match of the year. Michael Moore got dinged up a little bit, and so Justin is stepping in, and he's going to take on Matthew Ware. Both these guys had some varsity experience last year as freshmen. They're both sophomores. Both play football at their respective schools, and Matthew Ware plays on the Midland High baseball team. Been on several all-star teams in Midland, and I've watched him for the last 8 years and coached him, and he's a fine baseball player, real hard worker. He's on the honor roll. He has a 4-point unweighted GPA, and he hopes to attend the University of Michigan someday for academics. A lot of movement here between these two, a lot of energy. Looks like Matthew's really pushing the pace.
Not a lot of scoring yet, though.
There's a shot by Justin. He had his head
Matthew
down.
Matthew sprawled out hard on him.
Mm-hmm.
Well, looks unsteady on his hips.
Ooh, that was...
Justin probably would have had him if they weren't out of bounds.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was a nice drive by Dustin. Or Justin, I'm sorry. Matthew's not going to make many mistakes, I know that. Real smart athlete.
That was a nice shot and a nice takedown right there.
Absolutely. Looks like he's getting a tilt here. He's trying to get some near fall. Didn't expose the back enough. All right, stoppage, you're coming back center. Justin will be in the down position. Justin's on bottom trying to get some hand control. If you can keep wrist control or hand control when you're on bottom, it makes it hard for that top guy to work his moves. And he's up to his
Justin's
feet.
He's up to his feet. Needs to run the
hips away. Oh, out of bounds again.
Needs to keep track of where he's at.
Yeah, he needed to start that transition a little bit earlier to stay in bounds. Matthew switching up sides as far as where he's starting. Make it a little more difficult for Justin to figure out where Matthew's coming from.
He's going for a bundle there.
Yeah,
he's got both hands underneath. It doesn't look like they're around his shoulder, though,
yeah,
and Justin's got that ankle.
He's not deep enough, but that is what Matthew was going for. So it was Midland High's choice, and Matthew deferred. And Dow High chose the down position.
And they just put him back up.
Yep, Matthew lets him up, which gives Justin 1 point. They feel that they can take guys down, and I know Coach Donovan likes his guys on their feet in the neutral position, and you know there's that philosophy that takedowns win matches, and you got to be able to take guys down, and they're confident on their feet at Midland High.
Justin shot, but Matthew's looks like in a better position there.
Mm-hmm. Justin's going to have a better setup, and he's just diving in right now with his head down.
Matthew has to spin behind. He can make it if he goes for it. Justin's not touching him at all.
Justin's got to get off his
knees.
He
has no hold.
Matthew's going
to... either going to end up out of bounds.
Mm-hmm. Coming back center. Matthew Ware is up 2-1. Starting neutral. Matthew's on the aggressive. That was a really nice high crotch to a dump, like a fireman's dump. Very fast and explosive with that shot. Cutting them loose. They're going to give Justin 1 point. And again, they think they can take him down, and they've proven it so far with 2 takedowns. So we're going to score a 4-2.
Justin shot this time.
Mm-hmm. Justin's very strong.
Matthew Stroll.
Very strong. Lives on a farm, and I know he does a lot of work out there that helps build his strength. Right now he's got to get a better setup, though, to get in deeper. Matthew's just too solid with his sprawls. I think if Matthew had kept his right toe in bounds, that would have been 2 points takedown. That was a nice move by Matthew Ware. Little hand fighting going on right now. Matthew's trying to, he worked off that Russian arm tie before to get that high crotch. Well, there he is in deep again, but Justin sprawled pretty well on that one.
Mm-hmm.
He can spin behind in 5 seconds. He could get 2 takedown, but Matthew's back up on his feet.
They're both looking a little bit tired.
Oh, there's
more tired than they were at the start. That should be 2 points.
That was close. I think if Matthew would have stepped his left foot over the top of Justin, I think the ref would have awarded him 2 points. So 4-2 going in. A lot of action in this one. Not a ton of scoring, but a lot of movement. Justin's going to have to put him on his back to get some points.
See, Justin's got his wrist. Matthew's fighting for it back. Now he's standing up.
Matthew had a nice knee slide there to get up to his feet. Justin brought him back down, tried to get a little roll and get some points on a tilt.
Now he's got to get that wrist out.
Mm-hmm. And this has been,
and
a
been in this position before.
Yes, they have. This one definitely favors Matthew right now. He doesn't have to score. He can stay there and wear Justin down, and then
they're finally in the middle instead of out of bounds doing that. So Matthew spins behind, he can score. There's nothing stopping him.
So he gave the official awarded Matthew 1 point escape. He lost control and then went right into a takedown. So that's a quick 3 point change.
Now he's letting
him
back up again.
Matthew, and let him back up.
And here we are.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we've seen this one. We've seen this position a little bit.
How do you think this one turns out?
Yeah, I'm betting that Matthew's going to ride this out here or get himself
two more. He's got 30 more seconds.
Got a score of,
I think,
7-3.
If you get two more quick takedowns, does that turn into a major instead of a minor now?
It would, yes.
But
this is, well, 15 seconds. They're going to cut him loose. Oh, no,
he's going to go for it. He's going to try and pin him
back.
Justin's going to be too strong for that.
Mm-hmm. They're down to 2 seconds. That's a nice win by Matthew Ware. Very aggressive.
Fought hard for that.
Justin fought hard. That was his first match of the season. And they were hoping Matthew was going to get. If he'd have won by 8 points, that would have gave his team a total of 4. Oh, they are showing 4 points up there. Maybe I misread the
score. 3-9.
3-9, okay. All right, here we've got Brennan Doyle and Sam Hine, both freshmen. These guys, I know Brennan has not wrestled another freshman this year, and I think Sam's in a similar boat. These guys are at 140 pounds and see very few freshmen in their weight class, so this one has the makings to be a real good match. Both have a lot of youth experience. Both play football for their schools, and Brennan plays baseball also. Feeling each other out here. Little hand fighting, tying up. Sam's a little longer than Brennan is. not giving each other a lot of space here. They both like it nose to nose.
Neither of them are being super aggressive right now either.
No.
Looks like he's going for a...
Brennan trying to slide by there.
Looks like Sam wanted to duck under.
Neither one of them has real good head position right now. They're going ear to ear. A lot of coaches like you, you know, forehead in their temple. Create an angle.
I don't know if any coach likes ear to ear.
Yeah, no, not many, that's for sure. Not a lot you can do from there. There's a shot by Sam. Good sprawl by Brennan. Got about 40 seconds left in this first period.
There's a shot
there. Sam's got it in deep. Brennan's got his hips around.
Sam's going to try and step over there, work up the body.
Brennan's got to get his hips around. Sam's got him tight.
Going to be close here to see if this goes or not.
If they're going to give him a takedown. Out of bounds. Okay, that was a good scramble. Down to 10 seconds. Both of them sprawl pretty well. Probably not going to see any scoring here.
No.
He could hit that slide by a little earlier. Okay, no scoring in this, so Brennan chose down rather than deferring because you want to be the wrestler to score first. If you get in a situation where there's a tie, the wrestler that scores
Brennan
first.
Switch there.
Yeah, the wrestler that scores first would have choice in overtime. And it comes down to criteria, too. If the two teams tie, you end up with whoever scores first the most for your team.
They Sam corrected the team score over there.
Sam's got a, 9-3. Sam's got a crotch pry, uses those long arms to his advantage.
Brennan's trying to stand up, but he has that ankle.
Not a lot of movement going on. Sam's off to the side a little bit. He's got those hips. He's coming out with a Gazzoni move. Now
he needs to get up.
Brennan's underneath. He's got to get his knees off his knees.
Shouldn't have stopped moving.
If he can turn that corner.
He's got to pull that knee in.
Sam's pretty long. He's over top, and he's got that ankle of Brennan's. We're down to a minute in this period.
Turn him, face him, and get up. He'll have it, but back down.
That was a nice reaction by Sam there as soon as Brennan hit his feet.
Brennan's trying to get his hips around again.
If he gets his hips around, he could get a reversal here.
He's got his leg locked in there, but he's all the way off the side. He needs his weight on him.
Okay, there's two reversal. He's got a leg in, trying for a splits. Although Sam's in good position right now. He's in good position right now. He's got Brennan's leg. No change of position yet. Brennan's got to snap him down. So there's no position, no change of.
They're going to go out of bounds.
Yep, out of bounds. We got 8 seconds left in this period. Got to ride tough, not give up any points here.
Tried for a switch, but.
Sam tried
nothing.
For a switch. Brennan blocked it.
And the period's going to end.
Yep. My guess is that Sam's going to choose bottom. Brennan's got to ride him out, or if they come up to their feet, basically it comes down to a takedown.
Come on, Sam!
Sam's up to his feet.
Sam stood up off the whistle.
And
will
they're
going to
give him one. Yep. They're going to give him one right there. That's a good call. He got chest to chest with Brennan and created a little separation. Brennan going with that underhook.
Brennan wants to slide by again.
This match is going to come down to a takedown. near
wrist
the,
control
near
there,
the boundaries.
Spin behind.
There we go. Oh, I don't know.
Takedown.
I don't know about that one, but ref has a, certainly a better angle than we do. That would have been a big takedown right there.
Good shot off the whistle.
That was a real nice shot.
Same thing as before. Dennis trying to get his hips around. He's trying to put his hip down and get him onto his back.
He's got to get his...
He's really throwing his hip into him.
Yeah, Brennan's got to get his hip up, and Sam's got to get his hip into him.
He really needs his left arm on the other side of Brennan, though. He's not in a great position.
No, we need a...
Oh.
Two takedown green. Brennan's got a leg in right now, and I don't know that that's his strong point, but he likes to ride legs, wear down the opponent.
Well, he wants that splits is what it looks like.
Yeah, he's trying to get some near fall here. If he can get him over to his back. Sam's fighting it. That's a tough position for Sam to be in. There's a lot of pressure on his ribs, and he's doing a nice job of fighting that. He's got what's called a guillotine in right now, and we got potentially dangerous, which they stop the match if they think someone could potentially get injured. Shoulder, you know, doesn't look it like it's in a good position, or an elbow, and those refs will stop the match. They don't want to see anyone get hurt here.
Brennan's just pulling him on top of himself now, which is not
a great
move.
Position. Sam was in a pretty good position there.
Not enough time, and Brennan's got enough points. It'll probably turn out his way.
Yep, 4-1 right now with 5 seconds left. And that's the way this one's going to end up.
That's a good start for Dow so far.
Yeah, it is. That's a good match right there. It was a good start by Dow High. I think we're going to get into the meat of Midland High's lineup here, and they're gonna be tough. All right, at 145 pounds, we've got Jacob Hine, which is Sam's brother, who just wrestled, and we have Dustin Fletcher. Dustin Fletcher is a sophomore, and Jacob Hine is an 11th grader. Jacob played football as a freshman and sophomore at Midland High, and then he ran cross country this year. Dustin Fletcher, he plays soccer in the fall.
Quick shot by Midland High there, but nothing from it.
That was a nice sprawl by Dustin. These two wrestled at the Freeland tournament, which was over Christmas break, and actually Jacob Hine, I don't know the score, but Jacob Hine came out on top in that match. Both these guys have some youth and some middle school experience. Jacob tried to pass the elbow there to create an angle, and Dustin reacted pretty nicely.
A lot of tying up, a lot of fighting, but not a lot of real action right now.
And not a lot of shots or slide-bys, duck-unders.
Need to work on setting up a move and then hitting it explosively.
I think some of these guys are so used to each other. They've wrestled each other in youth and middle school, and they practice together at the different clubs that they've wrestled at. And, you know, a lot of times you're real familiar with somebody, and it makes it hard to get any offense going.
Oh, that was a nice shot.
He's got to keep that
out of bounds.
Yeah, that was a real nice shot there by Dustin. And Sam did a nice job of getting out of bounds. Not that he was fleeing the mat, but that's the way the scramble took him. And it worked out in his favor. All right, we've got 10 seconds left in this period. Looks like it's going to go to the second period is 0-0 also. If I'm not mistaken, it's going to be Midland High's choice. And yet they chose down two, which because they want that first point scored. That comes to play in any whether it's a tie goes into overtime between two wrestlers, or if the dual meet ends up in a tie, they go to criteria. And so you want as many takedowns before the other team, you want as many points scored before the other team, because that's part of the criteria. Looks like Dustin has a leg in here, and he too could be trying for a split.
Splits.
Sam's doing a nice job of fighting that. That actually, even if, well, if he gets him over a little more, he could get some near fall, but Sam's a strong kid.
And he knows what he's fighting against too, so.
He's doing a nice job. He's got a nice wide base. He's not letting Dustin turn him. And if Sam turns into Dustin hard into him towards his left, he could get a reversal here.
It looked like he was trying to break his grip there, but. Oh, turning into him. And he escaped.
Dustin probably should have let that go. What he was going for was a frame to face. He gets a near fall, and Jacob Hines just came right back after him.
He gets that arm around, he's got to get his head out, but he could well score here.
Yeah, Sam's in a good position. I'm sorry, not Sam, Jacob.
He gets his head out right now.
If he gets his head out, he's going to have 2 points.
Climb up the body a little bit. There it is.
There's the two. And like his brother, Jacob is very long and long arms. He can cradle you, he can bundle you. He can run a nice crotch pry and make it hard for that guy at the bottom to score any points.
He's going for the head lever there. He's gonna start running around.
Yeah, if he, oh, he's got the hammer.
He went for the hammer now.
Dustin was able to pull that back. If you get that hammer lock, that puts the guy in the bottom position in a real, real tough spot. We've got some blood time right now, and that's what it looks like. I don't know if Jacob has a bloody nose. Take care of that and put a nose plug in there.
All right, you're watching the H.H. Dow Midland High School Wrestling Meet on MPS-TV 190 on Charter Communications in Midland. You can also find the MPS-TV under channel 99 on AT&T's U-verse. This meet will be cable cast on the following dates and times: Thursday, January 14th through Sunday, January 17th. Thursdays at 9 p.m., Saturday and Sunday are at 11 a.m.
It looks like the action's going to start. It was Dow's choice, and Dustin Fletcher chose bottom. It's a 3-0 match right now. If he gets an escape or a reversal, he's right back in this match, and he's up to his feet.
He's already got an escape.
There
so takedown ties it up.
Oh, nice shot by Sam. He can reach you from a long distance.
Got those long arms.
Yep. Dustin's pretty scrappy, although.
And well, no points yet.
We got a whizzer, and Sam's got a seatbelt. Both can do a few different things from
tied
there.
And if Sam gets back up, he's going for that leg, but they're going to end up out of bounds.
That was a real nice scramble by both wrestlers. They
both
were both
did a real good job there.
They were both close.
And that would have been a big takedown too.
Yes. Oh, that may have sealed the deal right there for Jacob. A single leg sweep
hard on him,
and Sam
is going to start cross facing and trying to spin around, but
yeah, they came up to their feet nicely.
All right, back to being tied up, back and forth,
head fighting
hand for
fighting.
Position.
Got a minute left, boy.
When they're up on their feet like that, they're both trying to have their hands and arms on the inside. That's what you want to see as a wrestler, because it makes it easier to take your opponent down.
Yeah, you want to be inside their elbows, that's for sure.
Right, they go back down to the mat. That could be a takedown. That's a big takedown. Dustin's going to have to do a lot of scoring in the next 30 seconds.
Yeah, he's going to have to come up with
takedowns and an escape.
He'll have to come up with a 5-point move from bottom, and that's going to be awful tough.
especially against a good opponent.
Mm-hmm. Yep, Sam's got a, or I'm sorry, Jacob's got a nice tight waist there, and that just wears down your opponent. And we're getting close to 10 seconds here, and it looks like Midland High is going to take this match as well.
Oh, he's going to be scrambling. He's fighting for it, but he's only got 5 seconds left to finish it, which is not going to be enough time.
Dustin went for a sit out to a Peterson there, which if done successfully can lead to 5 points, but that was a good fought battle between the two wrestlers. Now we're up to the 152-pound weight class. For Dow High, that's Connor Moe, and I'm not sure who's coming out for Midland High. This could be Jesse Hayes. Yep, Jesse Hayes. Zach Donahue weighed in at 152 pounds also. But they're going to send Jesse Hayes out here, and Zach, I'm assuming, will go out at 160 pounds. Jesse Hayes is a 10th grader. His record is 7-6.
Kind of goes for a quick shot there, but doesn't look good for him right now. It could go either way. Jesse might get around, or Connor might pull his leg in and finish his takedown.
Yeah, Connor likes that leg sweep, and Jesse defended it well.
Sprawled hard there. It looks like he's broken that hand off his hip. Now he just needs to spin around. No, Connor still does have an arm on his leg. Mm-hmm.
Connor's got to get
now
off his
hands
knees.
Are off, so Jesse just needs to spin around. Connor's on his knees and has his face buried, which is a pretty awful position to be in.
Yeah, that's never a good spot for a wrestler. Fortunately, they called a stalemate, so they're back up on their feet.
It's like Jesse really likes pushing on his face.
He's popping that head, making it hard for Connor to stay focused. That's probably some sort of setup. He's going to pop the head and maybe get a shot in. There's a nice snap down right there by Jesse. It was very aggressive.
Started well, but did not.
It didn't end well, no. Fortunately for
Jesse.
He
was lucky he was out of bounds.
Yep, for sure.
Now, back to the same, circling.
We're under a minute here. We're at about 40 seconds for this period. Could be another one that goes into the second period, 0-0.
I think they just must not like scoring in the first period.
Yeah, and these
kids.
Makes
it too easy to win, right?
These kids are so amped up right now, wrestling their crosstown rival, that you never know what's going to happen out on the mat. Sometimes those nerves do you good, and sometimes they don't.
Still not a lot of action. They're just both waiting for this period to end.
Yep. I have to give a shout out to Connor Moe's sister, Karina. It's her birthday today. So happy birthday,
well, happy
Karina.
Happy birthday.
It'll be after your birthday when you hear this telecast, but. All right, Connor Moe chose down. It was Dow's choice. We want to get the first points.
He's way fast there. Now he's on his feet, but he's at the boundary line. Got to sag his hips away from him. Oh, he's going for the standing switch.
Switch.
He's got his arm around the leg. Now he's back there. If he can suck that knee in and drive the hip to the mat, he can reverse him.
Jesse's still in control. There's no points change, but Connor Moe's in a good spot right here. If he can keep driving in, and Jesse's doing what you want him to. He's pushing that head away. Just like in any other sport, wherever your head goes, that's where your body follows. And Jesse did a nice job of pushing that head away. That was a pretty explosive stand-up by Connor Moe. We'll see if he tries it again. Yep, he's on his feet.
Really, really fast to his feet.
Jesse did a nice job of bringing him back down. Looks like he's trying to get a bundle here. Jesse's got to come underneath. He's got the bundle locked up, but that's not the position you want your opponent in when you're working a bundle. Connor was able to get to his feet. Connor getting some instruction from Coach Hollingshead over there. Want him to hit that switch a little harder and faster. Drive his elbow down in towards Jesse's leg. Got an arm bar, Jesse does. If he can flatten Connor out, he can use that to work in a half Nelson or something to try and put him on his back, get some near fall.
Connor's moving pretty well though. Oh, now he's back down his stomach. Looks like he's gonna work a chicken wing in there.
He's trying to get
that
in.
Right arm. Having trouble. Got his wrist through now. And then
there's
a real quick half.
That
would have been a lot of trouble if he'd gotten it over.
Yeah, if he'd have got that any deeper, Connor Moe would have been in trouble. Connor looked like he's reaching for that leg, trying to get a Peterson here. If he can get wrist control, he might be able to do that. Jesse's riding him real nicely, though.
And he's going for that chicken wing again. Although not a lot of time. Same move. Work the chicken wing in and try to switch really fast for the half.
Yeah, he transitions into that nicely, Jesse.
Very
does.
Good. Real explosive. Just didn't work out either time for him.
Mm-hmm. Midland High chose down. We're looking to get an escape. Get on the board first. I always think the pressure's on the
score.
Yep, 0-0. I always think the pressure in the third period is on the person that's riding if you're in a time match.
Mm-hmm.
I think most wrestlers feel comfortable on bottom.
You spend half the period getting out and they haven't been able to take you down yet, you're in a good position to ride the match out and win.
Yep.
And he looks like he's going to make it away.
Connor,
good.
Yeah, he dropped nicely.
Grabbed the ankles and managed to stay on top of him.
Dropped nicely.
But Jesse was around real fast there. Now he's on the attack.
There we go. Now
this
Connor
could end up either way.
Connor could get a takedown, but Jesse battled that nicely. Out of bounds. That was close. So Jesse's up 1-0 right now. Yeah, I know there's different philosophies. Going into the third period as the guy on top, see a lot of wrestlers that will cut the man loose and give him a 1-0 lead because takedown usually wins it. If you go into overtime, you got to get a takedown to win it anyways. Oh, Jesse's real close. Got a takedown there.
Got another one.
Connor Moe's going to have to work fast. He's under a minute. Jesse's done a great job of riding.
Oh,
now he's got him
he's
in
got
a cradle.
Him to his back. No points, though.
Yep, there was a cradle attempt. He got him over nicely and was never able to fully expose the back.
Connor did a good job getting his shoulders back off the mat, too.
Yep. But Connor's in a tough position here. I'd almost rather him back out and get one and then try for a takedown because he's running out of time being buried underneath.
Gonna have to move fast, whatever he does.
Yep. There was a stalemate. They're gonna start. Connor Moe is still down. Jesse's riding. Jesse's in a pretty good spot here, up 3-0. Connor's gonna have to go for some sort of reversal to get some near fall too, maybe a Peterson or something.
Well,
where he can get Jesse on his back, but Jesse brings him right back down.
You know, I've seen matches won in less time than this, so it could still happen, but
true.
Doesn't look like it will.
Yep, down to 3 seconds. And
it's probably not enough time anymore.
That's a hard-fought match by both wrestlers.
It was a good match.
Tough wrestling on the mat. No takedowns, but those guys did a nice job. Jesse really rode well, and Connor did a lot of movement on bottom. He certainly didn't stand put. He did a lot of movement and couldn't get away.
A lot of good work, just didn't score any points with it.
Now this here is a marquee matchup with Zach Donahue. Zach Donahue and Austin Ream. These guys are both seniors. Austin was a state qualifier last year. Zach has had a lot of wins in his career here at Midland High. He was a regional qualifier as a junior. I think he had some injuries last year, which probably kept him from qualifying for that state tournament. These guys have known each other for a long time and battled through the youth programs, and this should be a good one.
Both just circling each other, tying up again.
Yep.
It
was a nice sprawl.
So he's
Zach
trying to back out of it now.
Yeah, Zach shot from a little bit too far away.
Austin has his arms, looks like, locked up around his head and arm. He's trying to sprawl, push him down to the mat.
He's got a front headlock there, which a lot of different things you can do. Zach is very strong and experienced, so he knows how to defend that. Zach got his start wrestling actually for Coach Hollingshead at the Bullet Creek Youth Wrestling Club, probably 9 or 10 years ago. And took a little hiatus from wrestling, and he was back in middle school and high school, which is good to see, because he's a good
he's a
wrestler.
Pretty good wrestler.
Yeah.
It's a long time to be under one coach.
Austin did a lot of youth wrestling as well. Got his start with the Midland Thunder, which is another club that Coach Hollingshead was involved in. And myself and Tim Kipfmiller, who's the Northeast coach, we all coached together there and coached a good number of these boys on both teams. That Midland Thunder's run through the community center. And they're still going strong. They got about 75 wrestlers in their youth program.
That's a lot of wrestlers in one room.
Yes, it is.
Midland's highest choice. They decided to go down.
Goes down. They're looking
for another match
where
no one scored in the first period.
Yeah. That seems to be all too common here. And I think
it's because they know each other so well.
They do. They do. And sometimes they don't make great decisions on their shots and get caught in bad spots.
It can be strange wrestling somebody you know that well. Either are too aggressive or too cautious.
Mm-hmm.
They seem to be all caution tonight.
Yep, Austin's trying
to call
the mouse trap. And Zach's really defending that well. Zach's pretty close to getting an escape here. He's just got to get his upper body out of there. But no, they went out of bounds. This was a matchup I was looking forward to seeing today.
Okay, it looks like it's going to be a good fight.
Mm-hmm.
Well, there's one escape.
There we go. And this is where Midland High is strong. They like being on their feet. They like takedowns. It's going to come down to a takedown here. You got 1:04 left. One of them scores, that puts him in a pretty good position going into the third period. There's a nice shot by Zach, and Austin really fought that off well.
Yeah.
Zach was in close before he started that shot. That's the way you want to do it.
So what happens when their arms are on the inside and you shoot, mm-hmm. though?
Yeah,
they
you
just
want
push you right off.
Yep. Yeah, you got to be inside the elbows. If you can stay inside the elbows, you got a better chance of getting to that wrestler's body.
A little bit of wrist fighting there. Then Zach probably wants to get his wrist back. Now he's out.
Oh, there's another nice one. Austin caught that. Down to about 10 seconds here in the second period.
Yep. A lot of fighting for position, but
mm-hmm.
not enough action.
No, there's... I would have liked to have seen by both teams a little more action from their feet, but they're doing a good job on the mats. A lot of mat wrestling. I think we have a little blood time here. This is Coach Donovan's second year at Midland High. He took them in his first year to a district championship, and then they went on to regionals, but he's doing a great job. Last year when they wrestled Dow High, I know they had some holes in their lineup, and those voids really hurt them. And this year, looking at his group, I think they're even better than last year, and I don't think they have any holes in their lineup. There's no voids. And they're not giving up 6 points because they don't have a wrestler at that weight class. And he's done a real nice job. Well, we're going into the third period, and Zach Donahue was up 1-0. So Austin's got 2 minutes to make something happen. And Zach, I'm sure, is going to work for a pin because
he's already got his escape.
Yeah, there it is, 1-1.
So now it's going to come down to a takedown, yep, either now or in overtime.
And that's what I started to talk about earlier a little bit. A lot of times wrestlers, if they're tied or even up one, will just cut a guy loose in the third period because you want to give yourself ample time to get a takedown. And you never know what's going to happen in a scramble when you're wrestling on the mats. And if you're riding and you get reversed or you get taken for a 5-point move, then that match ended pretty quickly, where if you let him up and give yourself an opportunity with a takedown, sometimes that's the best way to do it. Mm-hmm. I don't know that Zach intended to let him up, but here we are, 1-1. This is the position I'd like to be in. I'd be a little nervous if I was riding with 30 seconds left and only up 1 point.
Yep, anything can happen once they start getting desperate.
For sure. And we've seen it a couple times today. Guys are getting their hips high and giving up a reversal.
You know, they only have about 50 seconds left to score. Mm-hmm. Although they haven't.
They haven't really seen Austin shoot yet. He likes to tie up. He likes that front headlock, which he's got back in right now. If he can
trying to get around
by. Oh, he's back in that position.
But Zach got his leg around.
Oh.
He's got him in a mouse trap now.
Got him in a mouse trap.
No points, but he's trying to put him on his back.
Well,
and get the 5 points.
Yeah, they awarded
stalemate.
They awarded Austin 2 takedown there.
Oh, did
Austin,
they?
Yeah, Austin
I missed
is
that.
Up. Austin is up 3-1 with 19 seconds left.
Big bar probably got in the way of the ref.
Yeah,
it's hard to see through the railing here.
We don't have the greatest view, but we got a TV monitor in front of us, and so we do get to watch that. And if Zach can get out here, if he could have popped his head out, he could have gotten a reversal. If I was Austin, I might consider cutting him loose right here and going 3-2, and then staying on your feet for 8 seconds.
Oh,
and that's
going to be the match.
Yep, that's how it's going to end up, 3-1.
That can be dangerous tripping people forward like that.
Mm-hmm. That was an excellent match between these two seniors. Next, we're going to have Hunter Schneider, who's a junior at Midland High, and Zach Peterson, who's a senior at Midland High, or at Dow High, I'm sorry. Zach comes in with a record of 16-9, and Hunter comes in with a record of 18 wins and 2 losses.
It's a pretty good record.
Yeah, Hunter's a solid wrestler. He's a 2-time regional qualifier. He's done a lot of wrestling in the offseason. There's a quick 2 takedown by Hunter.
He's got his legs in quickly there, too.
He rides legs really well, and Hunter is a strong, strong kid. He's getting near fall. We haven't seen a lot of near fall. We haven't seen a lot of near fall today.
Only in Sammy's match, right?
Right.
Yep. That ended in the pin.
Yep. Yeah, near fall is when they're exposing the wrestler's back, but not pinning him. And so if you hold him there for a count of 2, you get 2 points. And if you hold him there for a count of 5,
I don't
you
like how he's got his shoulder
points.
There, though. Hunter. Because when he's got it tucked in that close, if the other person manages to turn into him, he goes straight to his back. He really needs to have it out a little farther. So if he turns into him, he just ends up back on his stomach and he's still in control.
Yeah, and Zach was not in any danger of being pinned there. But he was given up near for now. Hunter's got a real nice cradle locked up. And I don't know if Hunter's shoulder is underneath Zach's. This one, oh, I thought Zach was down there for a second. But he scrambled out of it nicely.
His leg's in an awkward position now.
Yeah, you got to watch. He gets tugging on that leg, and they'll stop it for potentially dangerous. But Zach's actually in a pretty good position here. He could get a reversal.
Oh, Hunter. And now a quick headlock.
Yeah, Hunter's too strong, and he got him in a headlock, and that's a tough position right there for Zach to be in. And there.
And a quick pin.
Yep, with 16 seconds left. Hunter Schneider got
in the first period.
Got the pin, yeah, in the first period. So that's going to give his team 6 points.
Should be 15-15 now, right?
I can't see for sure, but I think it might. Yeah, 15-15 is what it's going to be. Coach, can you give the rundown on how the points work for the teams, for those that may not know?
Yeah, so the way it works is if you end the match with a pin, like you just saw happen, the team earns 6 points. Now, when you see the wrestler scoring points, if one wrestler gets 15 points more than the other person he's wrestling, the match ends, it's called a tech fall, and the team earns 5 points. If they're wrestling and the match ends, and the one team is up by 8 or more points, they earn 4 points. And if you win by 7 points or less, you earn 3 points for your team.
Yep, so that's, you'll see a lot of times wrestlers that have a match won, but they want to get that tech fall to get extra points for their team, or they want to work for a pin to get extra points for their team. And I've seen a lot of dual meets where one team has won more matches, but the other team had more pins.
Yeah, and you see a lot of times, a lot of people still fighting hard in matches where they've lost a long time ago to save their team some points.
Yes. We have Devin Anzuret for Dow High, and I believe that's James Harris for Midland High. James is a freshman. He's got a couple years in youth experience for the Midland Thunder under his belt. And Devin does the same. Oh, there's a...
He had a front headlock, but he got thrown onto his back.
It was a nice takedown, and...
Now he's trying to lock his hands up. Yep. He's James bridging up to try and keep his shoulders off the mats, but...
Oh, James is doing a nice job of rolling.
He's going to try and roll through and get his stomach onto the mat.
Here we go, and that's what we call a five-point move. You get 2 points for a takedown, and then you go right into 3 points for a near fall. And James did a nice job of fighting there. Devin is a junior, and James is a freshman. And although they're similar in weight, sometimes those extra couple years of being in a high school weight room or just a little more puberty and development, that makes a big difference. And Devin's got that on him, and James is doing a real nice job fighting, though. Well, Evan's getting some, he's got a scissors around the body, and he doesn't quite have the shoulders. Oh, now he's starting to get near fall. You see that referee counting his hands. And once he gets to five, that's 3 points. And he won't award that until they come out of that position. Devin's a little high there. Oh, end of the first period. I believe the score is 8-0 right now. And Midland High is choosing the down position.
Well, he's quick up to his feet.
Yeah, quick stand up. James is a big
turning
kid, but
he's... face him, but he dropped down to his legs, so there are no points awarded yet.
Yep. Yeah, now
there
he gets his, they get chest to chest and James gets his 1 point. James is a big kid, but he's pretty athletic and moves well for his size. Devin is a defensive lineman for the Dow High football team and I believe played on the JV baseball team last year. James played offensive and defensive line too for the Chemics, and I'm sure he'll be playing baseball this spring as well. That was a nice positioning by James there. Devin looked like he had a pretty fast shot. This meet is going to be broadcast as early as tomorrow at 9 p.m. Oh, there's a nice takedown.
He's got him on his back.
James has got him on his back.
Ref starting to count. He could end up pinned here very easily.
That's a tough position.
It looks like he's pinned. That does not look good for Dow at all.
No, James has got him real tight. Devin's got to keep fighting. He's got 30 seconds left to fight, which is an eternity on there.
Forever when you're on your back like that. He needs to get that arm, his left arm underneath his head if he's going to pin him.
Yep. Looks like Devin may have his arm between their bodies, which is where he wants it. He's got to keep fighting.
That could be it.
There's 15 seconds. The crowd wants a pin. He sure looks like he's in a tough position right there, does Devin.
It must be his left shoulder that's up.
Oh,
I guess not after all.
Yep. Devin fought that for a long time. That's tough.
That was a big match. I mean, it's a big deal to come back if you're down by eight and then pin the person.
Yeah.
That's a tough match, and you know, he did a good job. Takes a lot of mental toughness to be able to come back from being on your back like that.
Yeah, because he was down. He was down 8-0.
And I mean, eight to nothing would win most of the matches we've seen tonight.
Absolutely.
Almost caught it.
Yeah, you almost got a
almost
towel.
Almost got hit with a t-shirt cannon.
Souvenir for doing the broadcast tonight.
If I'd played more baseball as a kid, I could have had it.
Just needed a baseball glove.
Oh, I mean, it hit me in the hand.
This is Evan Welter for Midland High and Shane Osverick for Dow High. They are both sophomores.
All right, back underway again.
Shane normally wrestles 189 for us, and Coach Hollingshead doing some jockeying with some of the kids, so we're making sure we're not avoiding any weights and trying to get matchups. And looks like Evan has a few pounds on Shane.
Yeah, he looks a little bit bigger than him.
Evan's record this year is 5 wins and 9 losses, and Shane's record are 2 wins and 1 loss. He hasn't had a lot of varsity matches this year.
It's hard to tell what'll happen in a situation like that.
Yeah, neither one of them had any youth experience. Oh, looks like Evan. Oh, that was a nice scramble by Shane. Shane might have the edge on the speed here. Evan looks like
that knee in,
sucking that leg in pretty nicely. He's in a good position right now.
Ooh, that was a good scramble.
Yeah, Shane came out of that nicely.
Turned the corner and put him on his butt the way that you're supposed to, but he rolled right over.
We could end up with it looks like Evan is working towards him. And as long as they're working for a better position, they're not going to call a stalemate. And Evan was doing that. Shane's done a real nice job of those two shots that Evan had and scrambled out of it for no points. Neither one of these guys had youth experience. Shane wrestled at Jefferson Middle School. I'm not sure if Evan wrestled at Northeast or not, but we got two big guys out here that are pretty lost, so these matches are actually pretty fun to watch. A lot of times they get real active and there's a lot of scoring, and they're a little less cautious than some of the other guys because they just want to go for it. And
they really have a lot of muscle to throw each other around when they're this big too.
Yes.
Not like when we go down to 103.
Mm-hmm. Boy, we should have kept track of how many of these matches went 0-0 in the first period, but I bet we're probably on the fifth one.
Oh, yeah, easily.
And so Midland High chose down.
Still trying to score that first point.
Yep. It's a tight match right now, 15-21. And you never know what's going to happen. If it comes down to a tie, you want to have first takedowns and you want to have first points scored. And that's going to help your team win a tiebreaker. Looks like Shane was doing a nice job keeping pressure, but Evan came up to his feet.
You know, it must be harder for them to escape when they're that much bigger. It's a lot of weight laying on top of you.
For sure. They both look like they're pretty strong. And
Shane was pretty high there, though, and it let Evan stand up, and now he's free.
There's 1 point for Evan.
It's always easier to score from the bottom than it is from the top.
Mm-hmm. Evan played center for the Chemex this year on the JV football team, and Shane was also an offensive lineman, so these guys were probably familiar with each other if either one of them played defense from the game this last fall. Shane played linebacker on defense. I'm not sure if Evan played defense or not. He does run track for the Chemex. He's a field guy, discus and shot put. There's a screw lock attempt. That's two for Evan. We've got a 3-0 score right now. I don't think Shane had that locked up well enough to try the throw. But you got to go for it. We've seen a lot of matches that
end of the second period.
Yep, not a lot of wrestling. And, there, Evan had him in a nice cradle, but...
But he was way out of bounds.
Yep. We've got 21 seconds here. Shane wants to give himself a better chance in the third period. He's going to have to get at least an escape. Go in there 3-1 instead of 3-0.
Yep, and then a takedown reversal will tie it up.
Evan's got a cradle locked in.
Got a cradle.
He's gonna,
points with that, though.
Nope, the referee counted one, which doesn't give you any near fall. He's got to get a two count in there.
And that's
there's the end of the second period. Evan is down, so he's got to work to get out from underneath. That's actually a good spot for Evan to be in. In a tough spot for Shane. Evan's up 3-0, soon to be, thought maybe he was going to get an escape there. Shane's got to work hard to try and put Evan on his back, work for a pin.
He's got the wrist control there. He's reaching in for a half,
mm-hmm.
but he didn't get it. A lot of hand fighting down there, but not a lot of movement.
Yeah. Shane's working to flatten him out.
Looks like he got another wrist underneath there, but he has to drive him forward and get him flat, but.
There we go, Evan got an escape.
Just popped right out.
Shane's gonna have to go for something big here. And Evan, they're gonna coach him to be a smart wrestler, not walk into any throws. He's gonna circle left to right, make sure he's not backing up. The ref may call some sort of stalling if he keeps backing up. Shane's looks like he's
looks
trying
like he's
to lock
up there.
Trying
he's
to lock up a
overhook and
trying to lock up a screw lock. And there, Evan was just cautioned. Oh, and there's the throw.
He's stalling. Looks like he's going to get a takedown out of that.
Yep.
He's got his hips down. He just needs to get out on top.
Yep.
And there's two.
You got a takedown. They're going to cut him loose. They want him to cut him loose because Shane's got to go for something big here and get another throw and get him on his back.
Yep. Even another takedown, even if he gets taken down again, he'll still win.
Right.
He really needs to get moving with that, though. He doesn't have enough time to stop.
They've already cautioned Evan for stalling. You get one caution, and then the next one.
That's the point.
Okay, so they just gave him a point. If
you got 9 seconds,
if Shane gets a takedown, it's a tie match. And he's got to get behind. He's only got 2 seconds.
1-0.
Oh, that was an exciting match.
That's fought out to the very end.
That was an exciting match. As we said earlier, both these guys, you know, don't have youth experience, and they probably had more excitement and more movement in their match than a lot of the other kids we've seen tonight. Both wrestled real hard. Evan did a good job after he got thrown not to not to go to his back. Now, these are the heavyweights. Brent Booth is normally Dow High's 215-pounder. He's 22-4 right now.
Good record, a lot of matches, too.
Yeah, he's had a great year. This is Tristan Mapes. He's a senior. He comes in with an 8-8 record, and there's a quick takedown by Brent.
Mm-hmm. Brent must be giving up a lot of weight, too, but
yeah, Brent weighs
he looks a lot smaller than him.
Brent weighs about 200 pounds. He's, like I say, normally he's our 215-pounder.
But he Brent, got that takedown, and now mm-hmm. working to flatten him out.
Mm-hmm. Brent is in excellent shape. I've seen a lot of matches this year where he's been down going into the third period.
Looks like he's trying to start a bundle there. He's pushing his arm forward, trying to get a cross face so we can lock up on the tricep, mm-hmm. but he's not getting it.
Mm-hmm. Tristan doesn't have any youth experience, so the experience definitely goes to Brent in this one, and the size and strength probably to Tristan. After high school, Tristan is looking to enter the Air Force.
Brent's got the three.
He's got a power half. Power half looks like he's going over.
He's got a near fall now.
Yep. Yep. He's going to get the near fall.
Brent's got a good amount of time to lock that up tight. But it looks like Tristan might roll through this.
Tristan, yeah,
he's got to get that left arm between their bodies.
That's a long time to fight down there, that's for sure, when you got someone.
A lot of weight on your face down there. Brent takes it.
Brent Booth came up with a pin. That'll bring the team score 21 for Dow and 24 for the Chemex, if I'm reading that correctly. We don't have a great angle.
Yeah, I think that's going to be right. That's a close match.
That was very close.
Tight.
Yep.
I mean, we have four more to go?
I believe so.
We started at 125.
21 to 24. There we go. Yep. This is a tight one. We've got Logan Walco from Midland High. Logan is a very strong athlete. He's small, but he packs a punch. He's aggressive. Jacob Sweet is a 10th grader, and Jacob tried sprawling there, and Logan came in
right up and put back on the mat.
Quick takedown there, and this is a tough spot.
Now he's forcing that pancake in, throwing him to his back. He needs to get in a good position there, so his weight's on top of Jacob to keep him on the mat. But he's got a minute and a half to work with.
Yeah, he's got a lot of time.
He's got to get around to be perpendicular, though. He's flopping off the top of the head.
Oh. He's got him pretty tight. Jacob keeps fighting.
Jacob's
a pretty strong.
He's a strong wrestler.
Too.
He'll fight hard.
Yep.
Yeah.
Logan's in a real good spot right now. Jacob keeps fighting. You can see on your screen, these guys are down there giving it everything they have. He must have his right shoulder up. We're looking at the monitor here, and look like those shoulders are down, but he keeps working
fighting.
One up there.
He's got 45 seconds left, but he's been fighting a long time on his back already.
There's the pin. That was a good aggressive match by Logan.
Fifth.
Jacob certainly gave it a good effort. He never stopped fighting. All right, we are at the 112-pound weight class. Mateo Diaz, who had a fantastic youth career, and he's going to get a void. We don't have a wrestler. Dow High doesn't have a wrestler
at
112.
At Midland High's put the match away. They should have 36 points.
Yep, they are up 36 to 21.
With one match to go.
Yep.
Mateo Diaz was a state qualifier last year. He took second at the Saginaw Valley League tournament and placed both at regional or districts and then regionals and was a state qualifier. He hopes to go to CMU when he's done with high school. This is Kendero Killington and Jeff Shields from Dow High. Jeff is a new wrestler. He joined Dow High's team a couple weeks into the season. And he has a record of 3-5. And Kendero has a record of 14-8.
He really just charged him there. And it looks like it's not going to work out for him.
Yeah, Jeff is a very aggressive, strong kid. I think once he gets some experience, he's gonna do a real nice job for Dow High. Kendero is a sophomore, and Jeff is a ninth grader. And they're cutting him loose, so Coach Donovan wants them working takedowns. I saw last year they cut guys loose a lot. They're real confident on their feet. Kendero's in there for another nice high crotch to a dump. And
gotta work his way around. And there's
two takedown. Jeff's got to try and keep his head off the mat. Looks like Kendero's working a chicken wing. He's trying a chicken wing stack here, which is...
They rolled back over his head the other way.
Yeah, they rolled through the stack, which helped Jeff out.
Kendero's going to get... Almost a reversal there, but...
Kendero got three near fall. So it's now 7-1, and then... Jeff almost had that reversal, and now Kendero's back in control. He's got him on his back pretty tight there.
And that's it.
And there's another pin to end the match, or the meet, for the Chemics. They certainly poured it on those last several matches.
Yeah, it was really tight for most of the time, and then now... 42-21 doesn't look like it was close at all.
No, this was a good match, and the score, Midland High doubled them up, but I think it was a little more exciting and a little closer than that score indicates. There were some good matches, and these two teams will
get a couple pins, and the score blows open real fast.
Yeah, and those pins are they are definitely a motivation and a boost for the team. It picks you up, gets everyone excited. Midland High will be in action at Durand on Saturday the 16th, and then back at a Saginaw Valley meet next Wednesday against Arthur Hill and Mount Pleasant. Dow's varsity is off this Saturday, but the Dow JV team heads to Bay City Western. And the varsity team will be at Carmen Ainsworth next Wednesday for more Saginaw Valley League action, another dual meet. Well, congratulations to the Midland High Chemics. They did a great job tonight. Got a lot of pins when they needed them. Got some big wins. The turning point may have been when James Harris came through with a pin where he had to fight from 8-0 down and came back, showed a lot of heart. But there were some good matches here tonight, and want to wish both teams well and good luck in their coming tournaments and matches. You'll be able to watch this telecast Thursday, January 14th at 9 p.m. And then also, that's every day through January 17th at 9 p.m. And then again Saturday and Sunday, January 16th and 17th. At 11 a.m.
More dates and times to follow next week on MPS-TV 190. Check the Midland Public Schools website at www.midlandps.org. MCTV volunteers and staff will also record the Midland vs. Dow boys and girls basketball and boys swimming in February.
Well, we'd like to thank everybody for watching and tuning in. There was a good crowd here tonight. Always exciting when Dow High and Midland High do battle in any of the sports, and wish everyone a good rest of the wrestling season, and thanks for joining us.